rap music, hip hop music has become blackface. A lot of these people are rapping about lifestyles they've never lived, they will never live, and they know nothing about. And that is very scary. This is my channel, and today we are going to be discussing if rap music is damaging to society. Now, if you guys are not aware, I was recently on Fox Soul with Tammy Mack on her show, The Business of Being Black. Shout outs to all of y'all that watched and tuned in. It was a pretty good discussion to the point where we actually discussed doing a part two, because there was a lot of things that were not touched upon, hence why I'm making this video, because there were so many things I didn't get to say. I'm sure there's a lot of things that the other panelists did not get to say, but I was very, very honored to be on there. Shout outs to Tammy Mack, Alicia, and everyone else behind the scenes that made the show possible. Shout outs to all the other panelists. They were very, very insightful with their discussion. Seven, Vinny, Jasari, like, it was so incredible. I was very, very honored to be on there. Extremely nervous, but very, very honored.
The Mademoiselle.
Okay, so
why does rap music get a bad rap?
I heard everything that everyone said. And taking into consideration that I may be the youngest one here, I see it. But at the same time, this is something where as I was coming up, you know, people always told me, don't listen to rap. Rap is bad, especially because, you know, I'm of Haitian descent. And especially when it came to church, they would be like, oh, you know, music taking over your mind. Don't do that. You know, and I always thought it was nonsense. I was one of those people. I was very into rap. You throw any song at me from literally early 2000s to like 2013, I'll know every single lyric. Like, and even to this day, I still listen to a lot of rap, trap, and all of that. So I would never 100% cut it out. But I will say a lot of it is extremely detrimental, point blank period, because of the misogynoir, the misogynistic themes of it, the violence, the flex culture, the glorification of hood culture, and just a whole bunch of things. Like, we cannot just sit here and act like a lot of the things that is pushed in the music is not negative. And I know there's going to be a lot of people that try to sit there and be like, well, there's positive rap. And, you know, there's people that make rap music that is, you know, uplifting. Let's be real. Is that on the top 100 though? Is that the music that, if that was the case, would that be what we would be talking about today? This would not be a conversation, right? I understand that there's a lot of music that should be pushed to the masses that is very positive to our people, that our people should be listening to. But taking into consideration that a lot of kids and a lot of our people are hurting, don't have positive role models, and are looking to these artists that are talking about popping pills, talking about robbing, shooting, killing, talking about lifestyle that they don't live. Because let's be real, a lot of these artists have been called out for speaking about things in their music that isn't real. So I can't say don't talk about your lifestyle, because that's the thing. I feel like music is about people's lifestyles. That's the whole point. That's how it started. It was by us, for us. And I feel like it was supposed to be positive. But over time, the gangster rap and all of that, it's like, okay, now y'all lying.
When I hear you say that, I automatically think, who's controlling these Billboard charts? Who's controlling the radio stations that lead to these songs going to number one and to being played over and over again? And a lot of people, there are conspiracy theories, a lot of people suggest that it is the white man that is infiltrating this music into our community in a way that makes us want to kill ourselves and be detrimental to our own community.
If you guys have not checked it out, I will link it down below. If there is a part two, I will definitely let you guys know. The people that was first to know the first time was the people on my Discord, and of course the people that were closest to me in my personal life. So if you really want to know when everything is really gonna go down the next time, make sure you hop onto my Discord and join there. Of course, you can always follow me on Instagram and all of that, because I'm always gonna be rolling out the details on there as well. Let me just put this disclaimer out there. I still listen to rap, I still listen to trap, and I still listen to all types of hip-hop, etc., whether it's positive, negative. But the thing is, I'm not easily manipulated by this type of music. At one point I was, but I can't say it really negatively affected me that much. Maybe it did and I just didn't notice, but a lot of this youth is, and we see it. Okay, we can't act like we don't.
A lot of these people refuse to go to therapy, refuse to talk to people in real life, and they living off of mantras and they fave music, okay? They sitting here listening to everything that their favorite rapper or singer or everyone in the media says as if it's Bible. And it's actually pretty damn scary. We cannot ignore the fact that there's been 21 rappers that were killed just this year alone. We cannot ignore that there's so many rappers that are not even making it past the age of 21, let alone, shit, sometimes 18. That's very scary, and a lot of it has to do with the lifestyle that rap does promote. Now, does that mean I want to destroy rap? Rap gotta go. I'm not going to be listening to it. No, but at the end of the day, I feel like we all have a social responsibility to talk about this and actually care about what our community is actually consuming, because it's affecting the children, it's affecting those that are easily manipulated, it's affecting those who actually cannot make cognitive decisions for themselves when they are at a low point. Music is very, very powerful. And as Troyce always loves to say, music is a spell. That is why a lot of this music has the low basses and the really, really catchy dances and the really, really catchy tones and shit that, like, some way, somehow you just can't get it out of your head. Like, just think about it. A lot of this music just has no meaning, no sense, no nothing, but some way, somehow it's always charting. And again, I understand there is positive rap. The positive does not outweigh the bad, and that's the real issue here. And it brings me to question, why is the positive rap not on the billboards? Why is it not charting? Why is it not as prominent or as popular as the mainstream music? So it makes me wonder, is it our fault because we're only consuming the bad music and it's charting? Because that's literally how media works. Just like how a lot of people be on YouTube like, oh, they don't support black creators. Okay, is it because you're not watching the black creators, or is it because they're not being pushed? Which one is it? We don't know. Is someone actually manipulating the algorithm? Is someone actually sitting there pushing the trash in front of us and saying, okay, we want the black community to be very low vibrational, so we're gonna push the trash to them. We want them to pop mollies, okay? We want them to pop molly on sweat and whoo, we want them to kill each other. We want them to kill themselves. So we're just gonna push all garbage and hope that they do damage. Is that what's going on? Or is it that what's selling, they're literally going to push what's selling because that's what we're buying? And comment down below what you think, because I feel like it could be a little bit of both. But at the end of the day, I feel like there's a lot going on there, and we're gonna get into that. First things first, I talked about this quite a few times on my channel, hence why I guess I was chosen to be on this panel. Second, I was shocked to see that I was the only woman on that show. I was like, oh Lord, like, this is about to be interesting. And everybody was an artist, okay? Everyone was an artist. I'm like, oh Lord. But I was very, very happy that Vinny basically said everything that I wanted to say for the most part, even though, like I said, there's a lot of things I didn't get to say. There's a lot of points that I feel like a lot of people touch on that I feel like are just very, very weak in this discussion. So we're just gonna throw those out right now, okay?
Why does rap always get such a bad reputation? Rap is not the only genre of music that highlights violence and hypersexuality, misogynoir and misogynistic properties, etc.
Listen, we all know that, right? But understand, this is about rap music. This is about the business of being black. And to be honest with you, along with all my other content, it's geared towards black people. I'm a black woman. I grew up in a Haitian neighborhood. I grew up amongst Haitians and other black people, other minorities. Therefore, I only care about black people. I don't give a fuck about country music. I don't give a fuck about every other genre. Okay, and it really, really bothers me in a general sense when we're trying to have a serious conversation and trying to have like a real in-depth look at something that we may potentially be a part of the problem. Everyone just want to start going left field about, okay, but what about this? Okay, but why don't we blame that? That's not the point. Stay on topic, okay? Stay on topic. We are not talking about those things. Stop worrying about what other people are doing. I feel like in certain cases, it is okay to bring up those points because it makes a lot of sense. And this one, it's like, I feel like we have a social responsibility to care about our community and how that music makes us feel, how that music is translating to those who are weak-minded, those who don't have positive role models, those who are literally looking at these rappers who are rapping about shit that's probably not even their lifestyles and literally pushing it as something that is positive. And it's really, really frustrating when people just throw out the whole,
well, not all rap is negative.
Like, no shit, Sherlock. I feel like a lot of that is just common sense. And at that point, for everyone that's gonna comment that, I have to say, your card is declining. Okay, you know when you go to a store and you ain't got no money, you know damn well you got no business being in the damn store and the card... decline? Would you like the cops called? Because at this point, it's fraudulent, okay? At this point, I think it's a whole lot of cognitive dissonance going on. It's like people want to convince themselves that rap is not that bad because they don't want to admit that some way, somehow, all of us are the culprit for making this get as bad as it is. We bought the records. We listened to the music. My whole issue with rap is I feel like it started by us, for us. And sorry to say it, no disrespect to the white people watching this, because you know, I would assume y'all not like this, okay? The ones that watch me, y'all not like this, okay? Maybe your ancestors. Wait, that would be all this. You get the point. Maybe, yeah, some people down the line of your lineage might be like that, but I understand you're not like that. So this is not geared towards you. But I feel like the white man has taken music, okay? Hip hop music, rap music, or anything pertaining to black people, monetized it and used it to weaponize us, okay? And I've said this a couple times on my channel, rap music, hip hop music has become blackface. A lot of these people are rapping about lifestyles they've never lived, they will never live, and they know nothing about. And that is very scary. It's one thing if someone is rapping about their life. Who am I to say don't rap about your life, okay? If you really grew up in the gutter, if you really grew up having to shoot, kill, rob, strip to survive, I can't say don't rap about it, because at the end of the day, that's your life. And I feel like creative people, that's how they channel their art. Whether it's singing, writing, dancing, rapping, twerking, whatever. Your art is your art. However, when you really sitting here lying just to push records and you getting caught, that's where it's like, oh no.
Even when we're thinking about back in the day when these rappers would rap about their lifestyles, it cannot be compared to these rappers and what they talk about now. Think about Tupac. I made a G today, but I made it in a sleazy way compared to now, how they're glorifying all of these illegal activities that they're doing. Now they talk about, oh, I dropped out of school. Oh, I drugged him. Oh, I shot him. Oh, I do this, that, that, and the third to resolve my issues, and I don't give a fuck. Like, it's completely different. Like, back in the day, they would talk about how, you know, I did this, I did that, and I don't feel good about it. I'm trying to be a better person. I'm trying to make it out the hood. I'm trying to make it out of this lifestyle. Now it's like, I do this, I do that, I'll give a fuck. And even though I'm a millionaire, even though I make all this money, even though I flex all day, I'm still gonna do all this illegal shit. But then, you know, they shot, they this, that, and the third, they getting hurt, maimed, all of this goofy shit, and we still sitting here raising GoFundMe money for them, which makes no sense. It's like, we need to start understanding the disconnect between what these rappers be saying and the true lifestyles they really leading, because this shit don't add up. It don't add up at all, y'all.
There's a slew of rappers that have been caught literally lying about their lifestyles. You literally can look it up, but I'm gonna make the job easier for you. I have sources linked down below where there are rappers that have literally been exposed for either lying about their net worth, lying about where they grew up, lying about the lifestyle that they push, such as doing drugs and stuff, in their music. One being Future. We all know Future. All his music is about drugs, okay? You would think the man is a whole damn recovering, if not some sort of hardcore drug addict. How is he not a drug addict? But no, Future not no drug addict, okay? Future literally sat down in a few interviews saying that he does not do drugs. He's not into drugs like that. Juice WRLD said, oh, I started doing drugs and sipping lean because of your music.
I ran into some Percocets my freshman year. Niggas was calling me and my homie Klux, right? 3 years later, Future dropped 56 Nights. By the way, Future is the GOAT. Future dropped 56 Nights. Niggas is hitting my phone like, will you get all them perks from them Zans, woo? Like, because of some music. And like I said, I don't know if I said this earlier in here or in some having a convo with somebody else, but hearing that music at such a young age, nigga, I was trying to sip lean in sixth grade. Listening to Dirty Sprite 1. People that doing that shit because they like getting high and they going through stuff and they like addicted. Like, and then there's the people that do it for trends. And for the people that's really in the shit, it's not as easy as seeing somebody die and be like, oh my God, that's a wake up call. I'm gonna stop.
I'm sorry. Where did that land, Juice WRLD? Okay. That's all I gotta say. That's a perfect example of how a lot of these kids are looking towards celebrities as role models. And a lot of you are probably like, well, that's not the celebrity's fault.
I'm sorry. RIP Juice WRLD, RIP to anyone who literally picked up a drug and passed away because their fave decided to, or didn't even live that lifestyle and decided to pick money over common sense. honestly, my heart goes out to anybody who is in this type of situation. I am so fucking disgusted by anyone who has the nerve, gall, audacity to defend this behavior. It actually really infuriates the hell out of me. Like, when I was looking into this and I realized, like, that this is why he started doing drugs, like, it really actually genuinely pissed me off. Like, I'm genuinely mad because I never really understood the gravity of how bad this shit really hits a lot of kids until I started looking into it. Like, I started doing my notes for the, you know, panel, and I was like, wow, nah, this shit, it has to stop. And someone actually has to talk about this. Like, it's one thing to like your faves, like your genre of music, but you can't ignore the flaws of something you like. Okay, like I said, I'm still gonna listen to trap and rap and stuff. I don't listen to it as much as I used to, but you can like something and still acknowledge that something is wrong. Okay, two things can be true at the same time. Okay, you can say I like this, but still say this thing has its flaws. It's all right. But to sit there and try to be like, oh well, it's fucked up, but oh well, it is what it is. Oh well, there's nothing wrong with this. Oh well, that's fucked up. It just is. I can't tell y'all how fucking mad that shit made me when I looked into this shit, because like, he was so young and his music is so dope. Like, I love Juice WRLD. Like, RIP Juice WRLD. RIP to anyone in general who literally picked up a drug just because their fave was rapping about drugs, or anybody that's been influenced simply because of shitty ass role models. Because like, yo, I don't think y'all understand how mind blown this shit had me. Like, I'm very upset. Like, furious. That could be your kid, your brother, your cousin, your friend. And it just annoys the fuck out of me how people can't put themselves in other people's situations. Instead, they just choose to say ignorant shit. Like, it truly annoys the hell out of me.
People should be able to make music about what they want to, yada, yada. And I understand that. And I know someone was gonna try to pull that card too. And again, decline. It's declining. The problem here is, you guys need to understand, we have to, again, have the social responsibility to care about these things, because these kids are our future. These are not just kids that are like, okay, well, not my kid, not my problem. These are kids that are going to be interacting with your kids. These are kids that are going to be working the next fields of life. They're going to be the next doctors, lawyers, officers, or whatever the case may be. We need to care about their welfare. They might be playing with your kids. They might be doing nipote kwa, whatever the case may be. They will be living amongst our society. And for us to just not give a fuck to the point where we just let them consume any and everything because, oh, well, that's not my kid. Oh, I don't give a shit. I don't understand why nobody doesn't find that an issue. Like, I really have a genuine issue with it. Back in the day, I thought that this was a whole bunch of rubble, okay? I thought this was a whole bunch of rubbish. Like, I remember going to church, and I'll try to put on my little music, my little MP3 player, shit like that, and they used to be like, oh, it's demonic, it's extra, it's that, and I used to be like, it's crackable. I used to be like, this is nonsense. As I gotten older, I realized, yeah, this may not be the most positive music. I understand what they're talking about. Does it make me want to do anything? No. But I feel like a lot of people that I grew up with, especially coming from the hood, a lot of them are influenced by this music. I've been losing friends due to gun violence and other type of violence since I was like 14. And it's sad because a lot of them are into this lifestyle. A lot of them are rappers. A lot of them literally are in this lifestyle. They want to be in this lifestyle. They glorize this lifestyle. Whether they're rapping about their lifestyles or not, and this actually goes to that other point of, okay, well, it's their life, they should talk about it. It gives a negative perception that all Black people come from the hood. All Black people was sitting here doing drugs, this, that, and the third. And it's crazy because a lot of Black people hate this stereotype, right? A lot of Black people be like, oh, well, I don't like that. You know, everybody be looking at me like I don't have a daddy. Everybody be looking at me like I come from the hood. Everybody be looking at, why, where do you think they get this shit from? A lot of white people or a lot of people of other races have probably never come across Black people, okay? The only way that they know about us is through music, is through society, is through social media. So when they literally seeing that a majority of our music that is trending is talking about rob, shoot, kill, what the fuck do you think they're gonna, like, let's be real, where do you think these negative stereotypes come from? And of course, music is not the only negative situation that we're talking about that has a negative impact on society. But again, what did I say? Stick to the motherfucking subject. But I'm saying this has a very huge negative impact, and it's something that does need to be addressed. And it's something that I feel like a lot of people kind of glaze over it because, you know, they still want to bump their, you know, trap and rap. And honestly, I'm still probably going to bump it. Like, I still bump it. I just don't listen to it as much as I used to because not only is the quality not there, the lyrics just don't resonate with me anymore. And it's just, I don't like the fact that it does negatively affect so many people. And this type of music did influence a lot of the violence that was inflicted on a lot of people that I lost. And point blank period, I'm never about to sit here, like, as much good as I've tried to find in this type of music, okay? When I sit down to make these videos, even when I sat down and wrote my notes for this debate, I tried to literally do the pros and cons, and I've always found way more cons than good. Because at the end of the day, people will always come with the same tired excuses, the same conscious rappers that, you know, always get the same notoriety. But to be honest, it will never outweigh the bad ones. And that is the problem here. You can name your Chance the Rapper, Kendrick Lamar's, and J. Cole all you want, but for the most part, those aren't the most mainstream ones. And for the most part, that's probably going to be the most you're going to get. You're not going to be able to name 50. Probably not even 30. That will be on the top 100 at the same damn time. At the same damn time. You see? It's ingrained, okay? At the end of the day, hip-hop is the culture, okay? Rap, at the end of the day, is going to be something that's going to be around for a long time. I just feel like it does need to be revamped. I feel like it does need a second look. I feel like it's one of those things where we need to start actually pushing for change. We should not be accepting this because I think they're really using us as pawns. They're emotionally controlling us because every single time something happens, every single time something, you know, political, emotional happens, all of a sudden there's certain music that's dropped that's kind of turning our attention away from it. And like I said, with the blackface thing, who's the one behind all these things? When you're looking at the executives of Sony, the executives of Universal, and all the other executives of all the major record labels, they're white. This is music that is made for and black people. I really wish there was way more black owned major record labels. And we're not talking about these little labels that a couple of black people own, because a lot of them are still largely owned by these bigger record labels. A lot of these songwriters, these producers, and everybody else is owned by white people. That says a lot. This is why a lot of these artists be still doing all of this illegal shit. And when they die, we still paying GoFundMes for them, which makes no sense. Y'all make all this money, right? Lie. Bow Wow lifestyle. Said what I said. It don't make sense. This shit just don't align. And I just can't support that anymore. It's annoying. Will I listen to songs now and then? Yes. If this shit come on, yeah, I still listen to it. But am I about to sit here and be like, it's not damaging our society? I can't sit here and say that. I just can't because I've seen it all around me. I've seen it all my life. And it's crazy because when you look at the older generation, I feel like they have such a better understanding because they had people actually talk to them. They had people actually teach them about, you know, real political community figures that did shit. Okay, that we don't got. For us, we waking up one day, we 12, 14, whatever, and we just hearing trap in a whole bunch of garbage. A lot of us will never know the meaning of what real genuine rap sounds like unless we go searching for it. But to be honest with you, the experience of someone that's like older, like over the age of like 35, 40, honestly older than that, someone that's over the age of 40, their experience versus someone that is like my age or younger is going to be extremely different. I feel like everyone my age can definitely agree, like for the most part, not everyone, but for the most part can agree that the music is just ridiculous at this point. Like, it's very low vibrational. It's extremely problematic, and we need to start taking a stand. Because I know there's a lot of people like, okay, well, why nobody said nothing about this person? Why nobody said nothing about that person? Nobody said anything because that's not our generation. Our generation is not standing for that shit anymore. Our generation said enough is enough. Our generation said, excuse me? Stop right there. No. Okay? That is not the same generation. You go question that generation as to why they didn't stop shit. You go question that generation as to why they let shit slide and let shit get to this point. Because at the end of the day, it started there and it ended here. And now we in a shit show and this shit is only gonna get worse. I feel like at the end of the day, rap music is a very powerful genre of music. Sadly, now it's being infiltrated by so many different things, so many different types of people, so many other genres of music, that it's becoming something else, and it's actually becoming very dangerous. I wouldn't say on a grand scheme of society, but mainly our society, because that's all I care about. Let's be real, like, I only care about black business. Like, everybody else, I don't give a fuck. But I feel like it's something that a lot of people refuse to look at and refuse to talk about, because I feel like a lot of people feel like, oh, well, if I have a negative opinion about this, or if I think it's detrimental, I can't listen to it anymore. No, you're allowed to have an opinion on something. You're allowed to be constructive. You're allowed to have an opinion about something that isn't the social norm, whatever the case may be, and still dibble and dabble, still listen, still support, or whatever the case may be. If you like the music, that's fine. But don't be ignorant of the fact that a lot of it can be detrimental. Shout out to all the rappers and the artists that are out here doing their damn thing. Okay, shout out to the rappers that's helping the community. Shout out to the rappers that are actually making conscious music, actually educating people, motivating people, uplifting people, because that's what we need. And I really hope one day we could start seeing them at the top, start seeing them charting, start hearing them on the radio, because right now, I don't see that happening, and that's something that we also need to do. We need to start holding these record labels accountable and start making a stand against them, because that's the only way that's going to change. We also kind of do and probably should not, and I know there's going to be probably someone that thinks about this, like maybe we should stop consuming the bad music and maybe they will change their lyrics, but I don't know. How do you think we can resolve this? I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions down below. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Follow me on social media. Everything that you guys ask me about is down in the description box below. Make sure you guys peep that before you leave. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye.